So here at Daly's Nursery, we're interested in producing food plants. These are plants that produce what you're going to eat, and we want to reduce the chemicals that we use on our plants. So in order to do that, we need to look at alternative ways of controlling pests and diseases, a more organic approach, an approach that integrates things into our environment. So in doing so, we actually incorporate some of the pests into our growing procedures and processes, our farming practices. So what we're going to talk about today is the good, the bad and the ugly. So these are the good bugs and the bad bugs. And here at Daly's, we have warm, humid polyhouses. This is where we grow things. And they're really great environments for things like two-spotted mites. And two-spotted mite is a common plant pest. So if you have a look at this plant here, this is a berry. It's called a keriberry. And you can see there are some yellow leaves and then some dark green leaves, which is the new growth. Now, these older leaves were infested with two-spotted mites. And what we did was we released some predatory mites into this area of the polyhouse. And these have actually controlled this problem on the plant. They've just predated them. They've fed on them. We need the two-spotted mites to feed the predatory mites. And we get a balance of the two. So what we actually get is a healthy plant. And we have a healthy environment that includes lots of different insects in our environment. We also have birds and reptiles and different animals that visit and live in our polyhouses. Some of the reptiles will control slugs, the birds will eat insects, so they're a really important part of our environment, and they actually make our working environment a better place because we live beside all the things that are a part of our environment, and we want to live beside the insects. So if you have insects on your plants, the first thing you need to do is to be able to identify them. And in order to do that, you actually need a magnifying glass. So I have here these pretty cool glasses. These are magnifying glasses, and you can identify pests with these. I have a little light, and they look super funky. And I've got here some leaves of the curry bush. So in order to see what's infecting these leaves, I need to be able to magnify it. And what I can see using these glasses is that the pests that have infected these leaves are no longer there. So this is old damage. It's not current damage. And if you look at these plants, these are the curry plants. So these also had an infestation of two-spotted mites. When we released the predatory mites, they took control of this infestation. So the predators had plenty of food. They feasted on these mites. They brought the problem back into balance. And you can see now we have this beautiful new growth on our plant. So what we want to try and help you to understand is that a bit of damage on your plants, a few eaten leaves, a little bit of discoloration is not a problem. It's actually a part of our environment. And if we want to live in a rich world with lots of insects and bugs, we need to reduce our chemical use. We need to stop using blanket insecticides to control pests, and we need to look at alternatives. So today we're going to look at what someone like Bugs for Bugs, a company that sells organic pest control, live insects to control your bugs, can offer you in your backyard, and what we're doing here at Daly's Nursery to control our insect pests.